Hi, everybody. I'm Chef Jean-Claude Apollon. Et voici and my son, Adonis Apollon. We are the chef in the RV. We're gonna show you recipe to make good food in your RV. You like good food? Tu aimes la bonne nourriture?
Ou
la bonne nourriture? I'm a chef very well known in the world. I used to have many television programs for the cooking, but I felt it was getting boring and everybody copied me, and I was the first one. And of course, I decided to go on YouTube because I know there's more people there. And one television program, one channel cannot pay me enough. So we'll go on the YouTube to make great money, show you the good kitchen, eh?
Wow.
So, before you start any recipe in a Winnebago, you want to make sure you open the oven and to take yourself a glass of wine, un verre de vin. Prends-toi un bon. Pourquoi je te propose un Boba Diet 1997? Boba Diet 1997. So here's for you. And for me, it's gonna be a little red wine. It comes from a small vignoble my friend owns in California, and he only sells that to me and to his Walmart customer. Walmart. So just a little bit of wine. This is German. A little bit of vin. Okay. Now, for the cooking, we will need un poivron, mushrooms, onion. Now, since we are not home and we don't have access to the kitchen we usually have, I just need some beef. I bought some beef pate. I didn't want to make, because you know, a chef like me usually makes cooking for thousands of people. Now we only need two of us in a small RV. I have to think smaller. Okay, first of all, we're gonna cut the vegetables and make them in a dice, and we're gonna rissole them. Alors Guillaume, nous allons commencer par éplucher. We'll begin with the onion. We remove the skin. Been around the world, I had tendency to pick up the accent where I stay. So let's cut this in dice. And Guillaume is gonna make them brown, very, for two persons, one onion. Now, Guillaume is gonna make them rissole. We need this. The beef. Like I say, I purchased that partly as a canette, but we need them brass. Il va mon fond. need to rush it by hand. You can do this. Bon, Philippe. Well, on a tablier, c'est pas pour rien. Let's go for the mushrooms now. We need to have the fans running. Sorry, people. We are cutting the mushrooms like this. We add this to the plate. You taste? C'est bien?
Yeah.
Continue. Now it's cold. I'm going to add a little bit of garlic and pepper. Why? Because this is the only spice we have in the RV. And we want a little bit spicy. Not too much. But a little bit. Let's put it like this. Whoop. Very little. See how it's going? I'm gonna cut the fan. Maybe you'll hear better. Eh? There you go. Make sure your fire is very high and you're well centered on the fire. Since you continue like this, the recipe, we need water that we put in the other pan. And we let this, this one. There we go. Continue, Guillaume. You're doing a great job. Very good. Et maintenant, and now, for the poivron. We got to make sure we don't have the center. Remove, and we remove. Let's cut. My chef, my assistant, is very hungry. I think he wants to eat very soon. But we have to make the soup, the sauce, very well done. Like this. L'autre partie, the rest, because we don't have room in the fridge for leftovers. So, when you start a recipe, you cook everything. Now this sauce will be quite chunky. But this is how the grand chef do it. Let this cook for 15-20 minutes. I want the meat well done and the vegetables tender. Okay, it has been green for 10-15 minutes. The meat is well cooked. There's a little bit of liquid in the bottom. And this liquid is part water, but also part fat. So I'm gonna strain it on the drain and remove most of the fat. There we go. is, you know, now that it's fat because it produced a flame. Now, if I was home, I would make my own sauce to go in it. But today, since we're far home, I decided to try a local product, the Ferrator's tomato and basil. So it's a local product. And we're gonna add it to the sauce. And if it's not gonna soft enough or too concentrated, we'll add some more sauce. I think, yes. Now we have sauce for 25 people here, but the sauce will keep in the fridge for a while. So we'll put another can of sauce. This one comes from my friend Mike. Mike is a friend of me, and he likes to make a nice design for his sauce. It's a recipe I gave him anyway. So we're gonna turn the fire down, and meanwhile our water is boiling. We need the salt. This is mer Mediterranean salt. Only use that. If you cannot, use the local salt. Salt is salt, but the Mediterranean one is better because it comes from different places. It's now mixed well, but it's not ready yet. We have to wait until we see the dark spot of oil, dark oil on the top. This will take some time, so maybe 20 minutes. While we wait for this to happen, the water is boiling. Now, since we are in a RV, I decided to buy those packets. You know, it's a one-person package. So you buy them for 25 cents. But at least this way, you don't have a package open that will spill and make a mess in the RV. So just open and boil those. You know, big spaghetti. It's not spaghettini. But you will like. Okay, the noodles are ready. We are going to strain them in the strainer. I'm not sure about the water here, so I will use source water. Now let's take a look at the sauce. The sauce. Yes. You see the dark top thing, the oil. You just have to move gently and lower the fire to the minimum. Your sauce is ready. It smells delicious. Yes, it's a good sauce. But the only thing is, I think I have enough for 75 persons. But it's okay. Like I say, I have a fridge. So we can keep it. Look at the big chunks there. Now, if you have children that look at your vegetable and have a big face, just put that in the blender. And mix it up, and it will look like a regular sauce, and they won't know that there are vegetables in there.
So this has been another episode of Cooking in the RV. I hope you like the spaghetti. Don't forget to accompany it with a good red wine or a spaghetti. C'est tout pour aujourd'hui. That's it for today, my friend. Stay tuned and see you in the next program.